In this video, I'm going to show you how to do this, what you see right here on my website, this scrolling animated text. I'm going to show you how to do it with Elementor in this video. Hi, my name is Adam from WPCrafter.com, where I make WordPress videos for non-techies. If you enjoy the content in this video, consider clicking on the subscribe button. And if you'd like video notifications, there's a little bell off to the right. If you click on that, YouTube will let you know when I upload a new video. Now, I get this question maybe once a week, twice a week. Hey, Adam, how do you do the scrolling text that you have on your homepage using Elementor? And up until today, I didn't have an answer for it because it's a little complicated to implement. And the Elementor gods decided, hey, this is something people want. This is something people are asking for. They probably read my mind, or maybe they're reading my emails. I don't know. But for some reason, they decided that they wanted Elementor Pro to have this as an option, and I'm going to show you how to use it and set it all up in this video. Now, first of all, you might want to ask yourself, why the heck would someone want some scrolling text on your website anyway? And there's a lot of reasons why. Number one, for me, I'm trying to get my point across without taking up so much space with text, because nothing is worse than having a text-heavy website. And so for me, I'm trying to have my point come across without having as text-heavy of a website. And it also is visually attractive, right? When you see that animation of the word changing, your eyes are kind of drawn to it, and you're able to have your, I'm able to have your attention on what I want to have you to have your attention on. And that's what scrolling and those words that are scrolling there. Let me actually give you a real world example. Here is a web page that I'm putting together, and we have this headline: when it comes to reliability, we are the one you need. And then we scroll down. It's a very nice looking web page, okay? So don't get me wrong there, but it is what it is. So with just a few minutes of using this new element that Elementor Pro just added, it's going to look like this. So I'm at the top, and now when you're looking at the headline, watch what happens. It's because I'm not going to refresh the page. I'm in Elementor right now. You see someone hit your page, that line's going to go across exactly where you want it to go across. And that is one way of using this animation. So what's the difference? When someone sees this, their eyes are drawn to what? That word reliability. And if you have a local business, and maybe you're an electrician, a plumber, a carpet cleaner, anyone that would go to someone's house, people want what? Reliability. And that's why I chose to underline the word reliability. It's a very subtle thing there that your eyes are immediately drawn to, right? Here's another example of it. If I scroll down right here, we have this little bit of text, and you can see what's happening. The word on the end is changing. This is the effect that's very similar to what you see on my website. It's changing. So you're able to not take up more space with text, get your message across, and draw people's attention to your unique selling proposition, and that's experience, hard work, mastery in this headline that I have right here. This is an amazing thing that you can add to your website, and now you can do it very easily with Elementor. So I'm going to use my Elementor hotkey. I'm going to hit Control P, and that's going to take it out of preview mode, and here it is. So when you update to the latest version of Elementor Pro, you're going to see a new Pro element right here called Animated Headline. And that's what we're going to use in order to create these animated headlines. So let me show you it in action. Actually, here, let me show you. So I'm going to click on this one that I already created. And when you start using this feature, this is what you're going to see. You have two different option styles. You have highlighted, and you have rotating. So this one right here is highlighted, and this right here is rotating. So those are the differences, and each of those styles are going to have different shapes as the word is here. Actually, I wonder if that word shape changes when I go like that. Okay, yeah, shapes and animations. Okay, so here we go. We have our shape, And I like this underline one because why it's subtle. A lot of these features that Elementor are giving us, if they're very powerful, but if you overuse it, it doesn't become subtle anymore and your website becomes a little heavy to look at and experience. That's what you want to avoid. You want to implement these in a subtle way. So what I wanted to do is I like this underline one, but there's other ones. So if you have a more fun website, here's the curly option. Check this out. It just does a cute little curly line underneath it. We also have the circle option, which I think is also would be very good here as well. It stands out just a little bit more than the underline did. And we have more and more. We've got double underlines. We've got strike throughs. We've got the X. Now, the X is actually really cool. Obviously, we wouldn't want to use X in this headline, but if you, say, have a page, a sales page, and you have a headline on it or some kind of visual thing where you're drawing people's eyes to maybe some kind of a negative thing that they're used to feeling, and then you strike that negative word out and then you show how your product or service solves that problem, these are nice little subtle things that are pretty nice and very powerful when used right. So you have these options. Before text, the highlighted text or the text that's going to have this animation applied to it. And then you have the after text, and you can do alignment, your HTML tag. Let's take a look at these style options we have because they're pretty awesome. So first of all, you can choose the colors of everything, the fonts of everything, the sizes, all of that. So for this, I chose this yellow for the animation because it went good with the blue, meaning it would stand out. Your eyes would immediately be drawn to this yellow, and that's why I like to do that. And that's also probably why a highlighter uses the color yellow. Okay, so we can do some rounded edges. Oh, here we go. We can change the thickness of it. So if I wanted it really thick, I could go like that. So you have that option as well. And for the headline, you have your font options, and that's pretty much what we have there. So let me go back to, I don't like that X because I want to underline reliability. There we go. Actually, I kind of like it better with the thick. It looks like it was a highlighter just underlining it right there. And I think if anyone came to this site and they were looking, their eye would immediately be drawn to this one word in the headline. Without it, this is what someone would be looking at. And there's nothing that says, look here. There's nothing that says, look at me. But the minute you do this and you put that underlining in there, it's saying, look at me. And it's a positive word reliability that you want associated with you. That is the power of this new feature. Let me get out of preview mode and show you the text options. And here we go as well. So we have these different animation options. So we have the typing. I don't like the typing that much because you see it's going to do the backspace and then the front part kind of collapses in. I don't like that much. I think that would probably work if the text was left aligned, but this is centered, so it doesn't really work that well. We have a clip. This is another option. Let's see what this is going to look like. It looks very similar. Here's the flip option, and that's going to just flip the rotation of the words in like that. Swirl, I think that's a little too much for me. Let's take a look at swirl. Actually, that is not that bad. It swirls the letters in. So there's these various options that you have here. That one's actually kind of cool as well. So let's see, what was the one that I was using? It was, I think it might have been that, or the slide down. That was what I was using, slide down. That is what I would use. So with this one, you're rotating text. So you have the bit of text before, and then you have the bit after, but what's sandwiched in between? This is where you're going to enter your different words or phrases or whatever you wanted rotating. You're probably going to want that main word that you want people's eyes to be focused on. And so that's the option we have there. And we have similar styling options here. We can change the color of just the highlighted word that's rotating. So we can put what we want there, the animated text, and you can have full control over all the styling of this here. So this is actually a big development, if you ask me. I think this is pretty huge that they added this. And honestly, I'm thinking, man, the cost of Elementor Pro just for this feature, to me, is actually worth it if you have the money, because Elementor Pro is really cheap anyway. It's only $50 and it will add so much to your website. But this is something that is really going to make your website stand out. It's going to make your website a lot more memorable. So anyways, this is this tool. I'd like to hear how you think is best to use this down in the comment section below. I have a bunch of Elementor videos coming up. I want to do one on creating landing pages, compare it to other landing page builders as well. If you don't have Elementor Pro, I do have a link in the video description box. I also have a course called Elementor Essentials. If you did purchase Elementor Pro through that link, I will give you access to Elementor Essentials as a thank you, or you could purchase the course. It's only $149. So anyways, this is this new awesome feature coming to Elementor. Finally, now when someone goes to my website and they see I've got this rotating text and they ask me, I finally have an answer for them. All you need is Elementor Pro, that animated text module that they just added. And they actually gave it features that I wish I had for this. I love that underlined feature. That is the feature for me. So anyways, I want to hear how you think it's best to use this, how you plan on using animated text module down in the video description below. I'll see you in the next video.